Many times you'll need to access the loop index while running a for loop. For example, let's say you want to print out the names of the most popular programming languages in GitHub in a sequential manner while also identifying its position in the list. To do this, you need to have access to the index of the list element while running the loop. One of the ways we can do this is with the built-in enumerate method, which allows us to idiomatically access the index of the list elements. Let's take a closer look at the enumerate function. If we use the enumerate function as is and give our popular languages list as the argument, it will return an enumerate object. To see what is inside it, we can convert the enumerate object to a list, and when we print the result, we see a list of tuples, with the first item in each tuple representing the index from the enumerate method, and the second item, which is our programming language from the popular languages list. In practice, we want to access both the index and the value from those tuples, so the most common way you'll see this is constructing a for loop with two iteration variables for our enumerate object, and then we can print them. I use the iteration variable names of index and item, but again, you could name them whatever you want to, like A and B. But because Python is a zero index language, the index starts at zero. What if we wanted to assign index to start at 1 or a different number? Rather than adding 1 to the index item, we can assign the keyword start to 1 in the enumerate method. While we're at it, let's customize our output string using fstring. And now we can see we have outputted the list beginning with the index numbers starting at 1. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.